One of the largest item sell-offs and economic declines that I've ever experienced as a player is occurring right now in Old School RuneScape. Many valued PVM items across the entire game are getting decimated in price as the economy aggressively downtrends. Within the past month, we saw the Twisted Bow dip below 1 billion GP, we also saw the Elysian regress underneath 1 billion GP as well, the Scythe traded around 500 mil flat, the Inquisitor also crashing down hard with the new set costing about 460 mil as I make this video. For players who are newer or do not follow the RuneScape economy very closely, this may be the first recession that they're seeing, and for them, it might be a little bit scary. In this video, I want to talk about why the OSRS economy is crashing, when we may see it come to an end, and how you can take advantage of these cheap prices while they last. Be sure to drop a like if you enjoy, and let's get into it. There are a couple main reasons why the economy is in a downtrend. The first and most recently hyped answer is the lack of item sinks throughout the game. When MMOs last for multiple years and items enter the game by the minute, it's really no surprise we're seeing a much higher supply of gear as time has gone on. When gear comes into the game, but the player base is not growing to meet the demand for the new supply, item prices will fall as circulating supply overcomes demand. If certain item sinks were implemented, items could be removed from the game, lowering the amount of items to match the player base count more closely, and we would see some economic recovery. I'm personally a big fan of item sinks because regardless of what is happening right now, it offers a lasting solution to fix some of Old School RuneScape's economic issues. Game population is another major reason why we're seeing a market crash. Currently, we're seeing OSRS experience a declining player base population. It's still higher than it was in 2018 and even 2019, but the game's active player base is falling rapidly since its peak height during the outbreak of the virus. You can see in the graph here that the active player base count peaked in November 11th of 2020 with 172,000 active players. Now that is insane. Unfortunately, since then though, we've been seeing the population count on a slow decline, with this week registering about 100,000 active players, which is a 41% decline since November of 2020. This decline in population causes extra supply to be in circulation, as players who are no longer playing could have sold the loot or items that they had to another player, increasing the economic supply. Another reason why there is a lack of demand for some of this gear is that OSRS right now is currently lacking a quality update horizon that would drive economic growth. Now, in the past, when larger initiatives are in development, such as Raids 1 or Raids 2, or any major content update that drives PVM, we see an economic run-up until the event happens and a big player base spike when the update drops. For all of 2021, well, let's just say that there's nothing major for the players to sink their teeth into from a PVM standpoint. Yes, there is combat achievements, clan revamps, and group Iron Man to look forward to, but these are not really updates that players are buying items for. I'm not complaining about all of the 2021 updates for Old School RuneScape, but there's nothing here that I really see is going to get the player base excited and drive the economy from a demand standpoint. This also might be the reason why we're seeing a continued decline in the player base count, but that's still speculation. The last major reason the economy is crashing is that GP is getting removed from the game. Midway through 2020, all the way to present time, the Jakex team has been taking a much larger stance against bots, and tons of GP that has been botted is getting removed. I remember seeing a tweet a while back from ModTwisted saying that he had a ton of accounts that had been banned, as well as about a trillion's worth of botted gold being removed from the game. Now that is amazing, congrats to the Jagex team for that. With gold being removed directly from the game though, and bots being banned, this actually makes your GP worth more. Think about it from an item perspective. If there were 5 Twisted Bows in the game, and 2 of them got removed from players because they were bots, and now there's only 3 Twisted Bows in the game, well, that Twisted Bow that you have is going to be worth a lot more as they become more rare. It's the same with gold. When a trillion GP is removed from the economy, that makes your cash stack more valuable, since there is less gold in circulation now. In times of gold deflation, players want to hold on to GP because in economic theory, it is going to be worth more than an asset or an item. This is the potential reason that players have sold their items in favor of having gold. Now, I know that this is going to be a big debate in the comments, and some people are going to comment, oh, bots are also ruining the economy, but I actually don't think that's the case. Bots have always been a big issue for old school RuneScape, and recently, the largest efforts in the game's history to remove bots has been taking place. Are there still bots? Yes. And yes, they still flood the market with items. But honestly, it has a very insignificant effect on the economy when compared to the normal player base. Do you not believe me? That's fine. Take a look at the item prices during 2019 and 2020. You'll see that peak item prices across all of the items, at least PVM related, in a time where bots were the most prevalent as gold selling was super lucrative due to demand. If you don't agree with my botting analysis though, let me know in the comments why you think bots are destroying the economy, because I've taken a look at it from all data standpoints and I really think that these other factors are playing a much bigger role. Now, how can we capitalize on these cheap prices? Well, it's actually pretty simple. If you're an average player who likes to buy gear or train their account and is playing RuneScape for the long term, it is about time to spend your money. In theory, the economy could continue to go lower, but these are some of the cheapest deals that we've seen since 2018 on all PVM items. Also, the economy is stabilizing a little bit as of right now and is showing some price resistance. If you've been holding off on buying some nice gear pieces, now is a good time to spend your money. If you're an investor like me though, we're gonna have to wait a little bit longer and see if this economic downtrend is truly over. Anyway, thanks for tuning into my economic rant. Hopefully the old school RuneScape market isn't decimating your bank value too much, and you're finding some other ways to keep your cash stack up. Drop a like, subscribe if you want to see more, and I'll see you all in the next video.